Hello, welcome back to another episode of Pillars of Eternity. So we are exploring the caves beneath Kawadnua Castle. I think I said that right, I hope I said that right. We were out of campfires. We've had some difficult battles so far. We found some looters that were pretty tough. We also read that there's like a monster down here somewhere. So I wonder if this could be like our first boss type thing.
Easy now.
I'm not sure. So let's
of course.
See what we got going on. Okay, this is a big room. I'm nervous about the big room. Leather armor, take it. Everybody over here? Oop, okay. So let's wound that.
Yeah. Yes.
Hope that's all there is. You shoot it? There's a bunch.
Got to get free.
Who got trapped? What? Oh, whoa. Finding web around us. Somehow he missed that. Okay, well, I guess that's a good thing. Ugh, we don't have hardly anything. Okay. Can't assault. And change over that. Everybody attack this guy. Kill him quickly. On this one. Okay.
Indeed.
There's another one over there.
Margrin's fire casts light in dark places.
What is this? Minor endurance. Okay. We'll take both of those. Whoa! Ooh! That is big. Okay. I know this is lame, but I'm gonna come back here and I'm gonna save. Because, wow, that thing is large. Okay. I imagine this is gonna take a few tries. Remember what I was saying, that hopefully we'll come across a boss? Well, we found it, but I am not sure we are ready to fight this.
Yes?
No, come back here.
I shall.
Okay.
Dang. Yes.
All right, there's more spiders. That thing is just massive.
I'm here.
Okay. We have been seen.
I'm here.
Okay. All right, there. Okay. All right, let's use some potions here. Nobody, we can't because they're not in the backpack. Dang it. Okay.
Most.
Okay.
Inconvenient.
Okay. Alright. You, sir, are going to burn it with fire. I want you attacking the baby one. You, sir, are going to use second wind. Alright, what do you got for me? I'm gonna put that on it. Busting wounds. Okay. Alright, so now I need you to heal some. You there. There. That little guy's almost dead. Okay. I'm gonna attack the big one. Alright. Let's see, accuracy 36. Okay. Alright, sir, what do you have for us? Barbs of condemnation on that thing. I don't want you to wound it again. What was it immune to? You, sir, go fight. Oh, we killed it. Wow. First try. I am genuinely surprised right now. Like, wow. Alright, what does he have? Spear Spider Queen. Unique stiletto, one-handed. What is 3DR bypass? Oh, okay. Damage reduction. I'm not going to read, but I am going to take it. Ladder Venom Sack. Wow, okay.
I'm here.
Let's save. I really can't believe that went so well. Odd Nua is where we are, not Kid Nua, by the way.
I'm here.
Wow. Alright, anything else? What is this? Weathered and covered with a dull patina, this elaborately carved pillar appears far older than the surrounding structure.
Yes?
Okay.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea, which is not very quiet.
Tiny spider, a pet. Far smaller than its wilder cousins, this pocket-sized spider has surprisingly alert little eyes. Oh, okay. Weird. We just gained a pet spider, it would appear.
I'm here.
Looks like we have to go up the stairs. Whoa. Is that Artra? What is that stuff? Can we walk on it? Jeez, apparently we can. Like, seriously. What is this massive thing? Okay. I guess we're going up. What is that? That's nuts. Like, more levels to the dungeon or something. I'm really surprised, like, we came upon it right then.
It's just like your breeches, scholar lad.
Huh?
I beg your pardon?
Nothing. I said nothing.
Okay. Where are we? Where's my map? Eastern Barbican. Bright Hollow. Okay, Bright Hollow we still need to check out. We have happy music playing now? What? Has this ever happened before? Okay, let's go back in and talk to the Stone Lady. Let's see what she... Marilyn or Marilyn... Whatever his name is, dead. You're a dead lady.
I felt Mayor Ward's passing. You slew him. It saddens me to hear it. But part of me is grateful to no longer have to wait and worry in darkness.
She's taking this well.
This place has always known its master, long as it's had one. It has a will all its own, which has little to do with the castle and much to do with the land it's built on. It looks to you as Mayor Wald's successor now, whether you care for it or not. A dubious honor, inheriting a fortress both broken and cursed. But in the right hands, it could be so much more. If you had only seen it in its day, will you stay?
You know what? I think I will. So let's say I've watched one of my own keep, even if it is a cursed. Steward, you feel that same emanation of warmth and energy in the air. Then it is yours, my lord. I cannot begin to tell you how glad that is, how good it is to know that the keep is in capable hands once again. Okay. Cool. I suppose I should mention first that if you mean to travel to Defiance Bay for supplies, there has been a complication of a kind. The Eastern Barbican collapsed decades ago, and Mirwald never got around to rebuilding it. The road here is a dead end. He got as far as gathering materials before he became preoccupied. I could make arrangements to have it repaired, if it is your will. When it ceased to be the previous master's will, I became powerless to do anything about it. For what am I but the master's instrument? It would take time, but far less than finding another route to Defiance Bay. Okay, how do I repair it? What does being the master entail? Okay, let's go with number two here. What does that mean? Why, there are many responsibilities involved in maintaining a keep. The extent to which you wish to get involved is entirely up to you, of course. But part of the reason I am here is to ensure that things run smoothly in your absence, provided we have been given instruction. If you instruct me on which repairs you wish to conduct next, I will make the necessary arrangements. These may take some time to finish, but each will provide you with additional resources once they are complete. Given somewhere to place them, we can hire tradesmen to provide you with supplies or ingredients. Repairing the keep will raise your prestige and draw both helpful individuals and unwelcome attention from bandits and opportunists. If we can raise the keep's security in turn, these will become less of a concern. You should know, however, that the position does come with some risk. Your name will grow in fame, and you must contend with threats to the keep. And then there are other things. Okay. What did you mean by risk? Merowald's curse was his own, a Watcher's curse. But his predecessors have not fared better. There is a presence within the keep, or rather, far beneath it. I think I just killed it. At least such has been the conclusion drawn by all who have come to this place. For what spirits still linger in the endless past, oft speak of a master below. Every effort to settle here has failed from the time of our Adiran colonist onward. Beasts rise from the endless past until the new lord or lady is no more. The one who dwells below, this master, does not tolerate rivals, it seems. I have seen from time to time intrepid explorers descend to lay claim to what answers they can, but none return. This is the force which has kept Caed Nua a barren ruin, and robbed me of my hopes. Who's this master below? I cannot say with any certainty. I believe it must be tied to the man said to have been the architect of the endless past, the tyrant. Ad Nua. Some claim his spirit endures, or at least has laid a curse upon the site. I cannot imagine much remains of his work, but for the ruins have been here 1,000 years or more. But what is left is impressive. The Earl certainly thought so. Okay. You may have seen while below the hand of the great statue Ad Nua constructed. Sorry, I can't read. Perhaps it is a statue of Ad Nua himself. Where are the endless paths? Endless Pass of Ad Nua, that is the name given to the labyrinth beneath the keep. The Earl, we were warned by the Glanfathans, that is, the site was cursed. And there is a legend attached to it, though at the time we thought nothing of it. The ruins were built, it is said, by a powerful Anguithan, named Ad Nua, who ruled there until his people turned against him. They destroyed his endless paths, and filled many of the upper tunnels in with soil and stone. No one living knows how far down the tunnel stretch, but few have ventured there to have returned. There is much talk of riches and treasure. The promise of Ingwithin relics also has drawn many fortune seekers to their deaths, I fear. Okay, but am I not the master of Caednoa? Of course you are. The keep would have no other. But the endless paths are a different thing entirely. It is unfortunate, really, that they are so closely entwined. If the master below is not dealt with, there will always be a threat to keep from within. I know it is much to take in, but if you would remain, if you would be lord of this place, then I can only advise you seek out this foe before it destroys you. Okay. Already did that, I think. How do I repair the barbican? Meriwald set aside materials for the barbican, and they are still available to you. In the future, if you wish to make further repairs to the keep, we will need coin for supplies and labor. Dang it. Alright. You must know this queen you're looking for. Defiance Bay has no queen. The Mequins of Adair haven't reigned here since the war. The only queen with any power is Wodica. I'm told they erected an exquisite temple in her honor there, but I was never able to see it. If you mean to go there, we can get started right away on repairing the barbican. You only need to tell me what you wish to do, and I'll make the necessary arrangements. Meriwald kept a ledger, as it happens, and I've taken the liberty of updating it. You could take a look if you wish. Okay, let me see what repairs I can make. Then we'll get underway at once. The steward's voice bellies, a giddy excitement. No, my lord, that this is but the first and least of a great many undertakings. The keep supported a great many buildings and servants for many years. If you wish it, we can repair some of the outlying structures, and these will bring you wealth and recognition, drawing people to your service. Rebuilding the defenses will keep your grounds from becoming overrun, as they did under Meriwald's keeping. You need not choose all at once. I am pledged to your aid, so as long as you are a master here, we shall always be linked. You need not step upon these grounds to speak with me. However, wherever your travels may take you, you can make your will known to me, if you but reach out. Oh, but first, of course, the barbican. Okay, how much? What is this? Upgrades to your stronghold cost money and take time to complete. Each upgrade can add security or prestige to the stronghold, or add additional functionality like resting bonuses, periodic free crafting ingredients, or new stores. Okay. What is this? Prestige. Okay. Okay, everything's kind of expensive. We did Bright Hall. I didn't even look as good as it does. Oh, okay. It's a house. Hey, I'll have somewhere to sleep. Eastern Barbican was already completed. Main keep. Whew. Did I not do this already? Thought I did. Okay. Alright, let's go back out. We don't have anywhere to rest right now. I don't have any camping supplies. So this is problematic. So let's see if we can clear out the rest of these enemies over here. They have happy music. I know there were still enemies over here. Are they all gone now? I'm curious to know. Whoa.
I'll see what I can find.
Camping supplies? If we can find camping supplies, I like that. The sour odors of rancid grain and spoiled fruit permeate the air. Dust and rusty utensils cover the countertop. We kind of have the happy music again, so I'm not going to sneak. The shelves creak under the books. Many of the covers are mottled with mildew. This place isn't in that bad a shape. Cobwebs bind the remains of broken alembic, a cracked mortar, and various shattered bottles and vials on the table. Alright, let's come over here. Oh, wait.
I'm here. Yes?
Aloth seems lost in thought. He flinches when you draw near, sucking a sharp breath through his teeth.
What can I do for you?
Are you alright?
Of course. Merely processing some of the unusual things we've seen lately.
Mm-hmm.
And if Meowald is to be believed, it would seem you've an uncertain future ahead.
I don't know what to think.
Perhaps Defiance Bay holds the answers we need.
Okay. Tell me about Adair. He looks at you in surprise. Forgotten your homeland already? No, mind. Matters here have certainly kept you occupied. I've been gone for more than a year now, but I suspect I'll always think of the forest and fields of Adair's home. We've thousands of years of history and tradition behind us, and there's a sense of dignity and responsibility that comes with that. Of course, there's baggage as well. Our imperial past is still fresh in the minds of many, as you have noticed here. It has been difficult to adjust to Deerwood. People here are informal, hot-blooded, his mouth twists into a wry smirk, more attentive to insult than to duty. But as long as one avoids provocation, it's easy enough to get along. He steeples his fingers. I've gotten accustomed enough to keeping my thoughts to myself anyway. How long were you in Gilded Vale? He shrugs, fidgeting with the hem of his sleeve. Not much longer than you. As you saw it, it was hardly the haven that had been advertised. Any thoughts on what I should do next? He tugs at his sleeves. Meowald urged you to seek out this leaden key. Agents in Defiance Bay, yes. And if his condition is any warning, we should find them with all haste. Okay, so he cares about me a little bit. That's nice of the dude. What's he got to say?
Poor Meowald. He couldn't contend with all that he knew of himself. A cruel fate.
Okay, I don't think knowledge was the problem. He said that if I can find out what caused this, it might help me. That is true. And there's no such thing in my experience as too much knowledge. Tana smiles. Come, we'll find your answers, and mine, I hope. Okay. Nobody else wants to talk to me. That's cool.
I'm here.
Rats skitter among the broken stairs. All right, is that it? Let's go back outside. Let's see. So are all the bad guys gone? Kind of, it looks like it. I don't know what's up with the amphitheater. It looks cool. I'm liking the music. Okay, they repaired it like almost immediately, didn't they? Just explore everything we got on. So Defiance Bay is where we're supposed to be headed. Let's see. Alright, so we're in Caed Nua. Okay, we've really come a long ways. I didn't realize we'd been to so many places. So we started up here, went to Veilwood, Gilded Vale, Agron's Fork, Anthlok's Compass, Black Meadow, Caed Nua, Twin Elms. I really... Defiance Bay is here. Alright, so it looks like we're gonna have to go here to the Wooden Plains before we do anything else. 18 hours! Alrighty, well, off we go. Hard to keep your stronghold built. Alright. New map. Who dis? Let's save. Okay. You still have to go back to that temple.
Yes?
Eventually.
Hello? Hello?
Dude. You were terrible at the sneaking thing. This looks like it would be a trap. Whoa. Memorials. Star Gellos, Benefactor, Lord, Jongler, Catalyst. Fool Dragon of the Obsidian Order, eternally in service to the Order. Michael Zoldag, Shutnov, Lord Torbjorn Granovic. Here lies an unfortunate lord who irresponsibly stored above his bed, poorly fastened, his powerful magical sword. That's funny. Tulamirsky? Tulanheku, this is in another language. The glow of fire shows the way through the night, and the wind will lead us home. Uber. He loved to run and run. Sometimes he didn't, but still he kept at it. Then he stopped, so here he is. This is weird. Mr. Visha. In his dying breath, he muttered the number 0451. What could it mean? Jeez, there's so... You know what? I wonder... That must be from the Kickstarters. I read something like... There are messages from Kickstarters. Or people that donated to the Kickstarter. You know what I mean? I wonder if that's what that is. Whoa, okay. Whoa. Primordial. And a troll. Holy smokes. This is probably a really dumb idea and a really stupid idea. But, yeah, we're going to try it. We're at the end of time for an episode anyways. Let's give it a shot.
I'm here, of course.
Okay. Dude, that dude's about to die. You know what? Forget this. I really need camping supplies before we fight anybody. Let's just see if we can get through here. Just gonna follow the path. Oh, great, there's a fork in the road. Ooh. And a dude to talk to.
Hush, Itumak. We'll just wait a little longer.
For what? Northwest of Defiance Bay. Okay, west of Defiance Bay. Yeah, what about east? Where does that go?
Of course.
The dwarven woman, dressed in skins and hides, leans against the road marker. Her face is turned down, her eyes darkened by a thick stripe of face paint. She's sharpening a bone or arrowhead and a shimshaw-handled knife. Her attention, however, is focused on a bear figurine between her feet. A large, white-furred fox standing at her heels looks up at your approach.
Easy, Itumak. It's not him. Short version? I'm looking for a very, very old friend. I'm not sure what skin he's wearing now, but I'll know him when I see him.
Can I help you find him? That's an interesting question. The last helpful stranger only succeeded in lightening my purse. I think I'll handle this on my own. Your friend is supposed to meet you here?
That's what I heard. Of course, the man who told me so was carrying a staff he claimed was made from dragon bone, but I know Whitewood when I see it. That should have been my first clue, but I had to try something.
Try something? What exactly are you talking about?
The long version. Here we go. I'm from an island to the far south called Nasitok. I came here looking for a village elder, a man we knew as Persok. I'm a hunter back home, so tracking someone wouldn't normally be a problem. But Persok's trail is cold, to say the least.
Let's see. How long have you been looking for Persok? Her painted brow lowers and her compact muscular frame sags, for instance. 5 years. That's a long time. Why can't you find him? There can't be that many of your people that you're with. He died when I was still a young girl. Forgot to mention that part, did I? I'm looking for his latest reincarnation, which could be anyone. So you've been searching 5 years for a stranger you barely remember who could be anyone now?
That about sums it up.
Why do you have to find Perso? It's more of a campfire tale I'm not quite ready to get into. Must be an important duty.
So I keep reminding myself. Still, it would be nice if important duties came with clearer instructions.
How does statuette figure into it? She dusts the figurine on her trousers and raises it in her small, flat palm. It's carved in the shape of a bear, smooth and round. The polished adra is worn to a dull mat along its arched back and avoid haunches. A soft glow emanates from within.
Cute, isn't it?
Whoa.
Before he returned to the wheel, he left a splinter of his soul in it. Something to help us find him later.
As she holds it out to you, you feel a wisp of sensation. Not quite memories, but traces of someone.
When I left Nasitok, it was completely dark inside. But as I've gotten closer to Persok, it's glowed steadily brighter. Since I've reached the Deerwood, however, it's gotten hard to read. Some days it flickers and goes dark.
I could take a look at it.
It shines nice and bright for a few hours. But most of the time, it looks just like this. I've heard that one before. Whole reason I'm standing here is because some so-called watcher from Forkedvale told me he could take a look. For a few golden dukes, of course. I was on my way out of the Balmarsh when I heard talk of a traveling mystic who could supposedly see souls. I knew it was a long shot, but what did I have to lose? I went to see this fellow and gave him the Audra figurine. He made a big show of moaning and rolling his eyes, and after I'd given him 5 golden dukes to lift the shroud, he told me to seek the crossroads in the field between the wolf's lair and the twining trees.
Go on.
He thought he was being vague, but I know the area well enough to recognize that he meant this place, right between Defiance Bay and Twin Elms. I had a bad taste in my mouth, but my coin was spent and I'd already left an arrow in his knapsack as a friendly warning. Told him I'd come back and leave him with another if it turned out he was giving me the runaround. I've been here a week now. Guess he had the last laugh after all.
May I see the figurine?
Why?
I just want a better look at it. Let's give her a surprise.
Fine. But if you try to run, just remember that my arrows are faster.
She hands you the figurine, her chapped knuckles grazing your hand. She watches you examine it, wary but curious. You raise the Adra bearer, turning it in the light. As your eyes catch a tiny glinting scratch, the scenery around you melts away. You're standing on a cliff, overlooking the water, seeing through eyes that aren't your own. You catch the musk of beasts amidst the fresh scent of vegetation. Your heart beats a little faster. You'll have to watch your step up here. You look down just long enough to see the sharp, pale cliffs drop into the water hundreds of feet below you. I see a vision of cliffs, high over the water. Does that sound familiar? The question is greeted with shrugs and silence. I've got it. He's standing on a cliff.
What are you talking about? What just happened?
I'm a real watcher. Yeah. She blinks it a few times, calculating. I know this sounds strange, but it is the truth, Aloth says.
You realize I've got no coin to give you, even if I did believe you.
Come with me. I've got other business in the area, and we can look for Persok on the way. Yeah, let's take her with us.
If this is your idea of a joke, you may be stuck with me for a while. Lead the way.
All right, we got a new person. Sweet.
I'm here.
Okay. So we need to be heading this way.
Hello?
Okay, so she is like me. She has a companion. Okay, so we are going to stop here. A little bit longer episode than normal, but hey, we beat a boss type character. Apparently not the right one. Sounds like we have to go looking for more. We got a stronghold and a new party member. I don't even know what was her name? Sagani. So yeah, that was a whole lot happening at once. Not only did we a party member, but she has a wolf with her. And I'm pumped because that's really like getting two party members. So awesome. Well, as always, guys, thank you for tuning in. Make sure to hit the like button. I appreciate it. It helps me out. And I will see you next time. Bye.